What is going on, everyone? Got a video here to share with all of you on how to use MFlash for flashing an MSI single BIOS slash UEFI. UEFI is kind of like the newer terminology for the word BIOS. Basically the same thing. We're going to be doing this with a USB pen drive or a USB flash drive. So I'm going to be showing you a few tips throughout the video, and it may help you if you're trying to flash another type of motherboard from another manufacturer. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to Google and go to MSI's official website. I'm going to be flashing the MSI X299 SLI Plus motherboard. So I want to make sure I go directly to MSI's website, and I'm going to go ahead and pull up my board here because I had searched for it previously and I did some downloads earlier. But here is where you want to be if you have an MSI motherboard and you're looking for yours. And you can go up here to the search thing and you can put in, you know, whatever board that you might have and try and find your board. So what you're looking for is these tabs across here. You can select your drivers, manual, and things like that. The one I'm gonna select is BIOS. The one at the top is usually the latest release. And this is like, you don't have to flash the BIOS if you don't want to, if your computer's working fine. I like to take advantage of stuff like that's down here in the description. Newer updates, you know, update ME driver, improve memory compatibility. Sometimes it can correct hardware issues and things like that. So once you're here and you find your BIOS, you can go ahead and click the little arrow. That's going to download the BIOS in a zipped folder. So once you download your file, you got to go in and find it. Now I put mine on the desktop because I'm doing a tutorial. So what we need to do is extract the contents that are in the file. We need to extract the BIOS file. So what you do is you go over top of it and you right click. You can choose if you have the built-in feature like I do. I'm on Windows 10 and I have this option here. It says extract all. You can select extract all, and that will actually create a new folder right next to this one on the desktop and extract the files for you. Or if you're a little more familiar with extraction programs and you're running like 7-zip or WinRAR, you can do it a little more quickly using one of these programs. So I'm just going to use 7-zip to do this, and I'm going to go to extract files, and then I'm going to click OK. That should create a new folder, and it popped up right up here at the top. So I'm going to move that over. Now I have the folder that has been unzipped or extracted, and we go in here and we find the files that we need to flash the BIOS. Here's the files that we need. So the next thing you want to do is go ahead and open up your directory where you can see your hard drives and things like that. Now I have an icon on my desktop that says this PC. Yours might say my computer if you're on an older OS like Windows 7 or something, or Windows 8. You need to be able to get to your devices and drives. So once you're in here to devices and drives, you need to plug in your USB flash drive. Now, what I recommend you do is at least have a flash drive. The one that's more widely compatible is like a 16 gig flash drive formatted in FAT32. Because I'm doing a tutorial, I'm actually plugging in my 64 gig drive. These are both SanDisk USB flash drives, but they are different sizes. And that's important for a few different reasons, which I'm gonna show you. So this one over here is a 16 gig USB flash drive. If I right click on that and I come down here to format, you'll notice I have under file system, I can do FAT32 or NTFS or XFAT. For this one, you want to do FAT32 if you have a 16 gig flash drive. For the 64 gig one over here, if I right click and go to format, you'll notice I don't have the option under file system for FAT32. It only supports NTFS because that's a newer file system, and usually 32 gigs is like where it changes over to NTFS and you no longer have use of FAT32. FAT32 is more compatible, you know, more widely compatible with a wider range of motherboards and operating systems. So I recommend you have at least a 16 gig drive. If you have something smaller, you just want to make sure you right click on it and you go to format and you choose FAT32. Basically 32 gigs or smaller, you're going to do FAT32. This is the recommended one to use when flashing a BIOS. So what you want to do is you want to go ahead and format that drive and make sure it's completely clean, because these USB drives do not need to be bootable. Okay, so once you have this drive all formatted and it's clean and it's FAT32, you wanna go over here to your folder and you wanna go in and get all the files that were in there, even the text file. You wanna right click and choose copy somehow or whatever you wanna do there, but you wanna move them over to that thumb drive. So then you can just close out of that and back out. Now, because I'm doing a tutorial, like I said, I'm gonna do the same thing on this drive over here that's formatted for NTFS. So I did go through and clean this one off. If you right click, go to format. I did already format it for NTFS, which I'll just do that again real quick. So I'm gonna do the same exact thing for this one. Go in here, get all the files, copy them, and I'm gonna put them into this drive here. So now I have two USB drives, and again, you only need one drive to do this. I'm just showing you two in case you have different drives. And one is FAT32, one is NTFS. So I'm getting ready to go ahead and I'm going to restart the computer here so I can get ready to flash the BIOS. First, I want to mention that when you are putting files into your thumb drives like this, you want to make sure they're formatted like we went through and that they are in the root directory. In other words, if there was a folder in here called music or you had something else on there, you don't want them in that folder. You want them right out here in the main part of the main root directory of the USB thumb drive. So the next thing you want to do before restarting the computer is you want to right click on your thumb drive, your USB flash drive, and you want to come down and choose eject. Now you can choose eject from there, or you can come over here and find the G drive over here and right click on it, and you can choose eject there, or you can come down in the taskbar area here and find it, and I think it's right here, and you can right click and choose eject. So what I'm going to do is right click on these and I'm going to eject both of them, and what that does is kind of release it from the operating system. That way when we reboot, it kind of gives it a clean detection for the BIOS and sometimes makes it a little more easily recognizable. I have tried it without ejecting and it's still, my BIOS is still able to recognize the drives, but I'm showing you to do it this way because more than likely the FAT32 USB drive here that you're probably using, as long as you eject that, it should recognize. So let's go ahead now, we're gonna restart the computer. Okay, so I had to switch over here to my other camera, that way you can see me reboot the computer and what I'm going to do to get into the BIOS to do the flash. So I'm gonna go ahead and restart the computer now. And as soon as you restart your computer, normally, at least for my setup with this board, you're gonna press a button repeatedly. So as soon as my screen goes out here, I'm gonna start pressing the delete key repeatedly. And then if you take notice to the lower left corner, you're gonna see it say entering setup or entering BIOS. So right now I'm clicking the delete key repeatedly nonstop until I see that message that's down in the lower left. Maybe something different for your setup, might be a different key or something. But now you can see it down there. Possibly it says entering setup, so I know that that's going to get me into the BIOS or UEFI. Okay, so once you're in here, now I'm going to go ahead and go to right down to where it says MFlash. I'm going to click MFlash. So what happens here is it's going to actually reboot and it's going to restore the default settings. That way when it writes the new BIOS, it's, you know, getting a clean setup as far as writing into a clean reset BIOS, so everything's recognized okay. Okay, so once you're into the MFlash screen, you should see your USB drive in here. This one at the top that says FS0 is my 16 gig that's formatted FAT32. This one down here is my extreme one that's formatted NTFS. So this is my 64 gig drive. Both drives are showing up for me and they are formatted differently, which does not matter. Basically what you're doing that FAT32 thing for or NTFS thing is so this BIOS can detect the drives in here. So like I said before, if you format FAT32 and you're using, you know, something like a 16 gig flash drive, it's probably going to be more detectable. It's more widely compatible. I'm just going to go ahead and select this one at the top. And then all you need to do is come over here and select the file. Before I click yes, if you guys are not, you know, if you're stuck here and you're not getting yours to show up, what you probably need to do is go back, reboot your computer, change USB ports, reformat your drive again, try, you know, maybe try FAT32 or try NTFS, redownload the files, copy them back in there, make sure nothing was corrupt. You can also try not ejecting the USB drive after your reboot and go back into the BIOS and see if it detects it that way, because sometimes that will work as well. So I'm just going to keep moving forward here. I'm going to click yes, I want to select this file. And basically it is updating the BIOS. And during this process, you don't want to touch anything. You don't want to shut the computer off. You don't want to do this in the middle of, I'm kind of being funny here, but like, you know, in the middle of a thunderstorm or lightning storm, probably when you're most likely likely to lose computer power, but you guys get my point. So it's basically going to write this new BIOS, and then it's all going to be, it should be all back to default settings, and you'll have to go in, if you guys customized your BIOS at all, you'll have to go back in and reset things the way you want them. Normally, because it goes back to default settings. Okay, so my BIOS flashed perfectly fine. You can see up here at the top on the right side there, I have the new BIOS version. The BIOS build date is 10/16/2019. Now everything is back to default settings, so I'll have to go through and clean mine up a little bit and customize it the way I want, but I'm going to go ahead and just reboot back into the computer and go to the desktop, and I'll finish this video up. Okay, I am back at the desktop now, and you can see both of my drives showed back up. Again, you will only have one drive more than likely, but I had two in here to show you the two different file systems, the NTFS and this one FAT32, that you could use either or. It's just which one will your BIOS detect. This one here that's FAT32 is the most widely compatible one. So if you do have that option of going in here and formatting FAT32, you want to do that. That's why I recommend a 16 gig drive or something like that, and nothing larger like this one. Although it will work, but you will only be able to format NTFS. So that is a little bit about that. And when we did go in and flash the BIOS, basically what it does is use a copy of these files. You can see they're still on there. So in order to get rid of them, you can either delete them or you can just go in here, and I'm just going to format the drive again so it's completely cleaned back off. I'm going to do that to both of them. This one I didn't use, again, tutorial purposes. I'm going to format this again, NTFS, and there we go. So all back to normal. Now I have two empty USB drives and my original BIOS files over here in case I need them again. So that's pretty much all I had for you. You know, if you guys are having trouble getting yours to show up, consult to your motherboard manual and see what you can find in there. You can go through and try this FAT32, NTFS. Whatever one you can get to show up in the BIOS is fine. If, you know, restart the computer, you can eject and then restart the computer, or you can leave it, you know, without ejecting and restart the computer, go in the BIOS, see which way works for you, see how you can get these files in here to show up in your BIOS so you're able to select them, and then you can flash your BIOS. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, hit the like button, and I will see you all soon in the next video. Thanks for watching.